विशाल बिगिन चैप्टर 14 ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स क्लास 11 मैथमेटिकल रीजनिंग। इन दिस चैप्टर विशाल डिस्कस अबाउट सम बेसिक आइडियाज ऑफ मैथमेटिकल रीजनिंग। ऑल ऑफ अस नो दैट ह्यूमन बीइंग्स इवॉल्व्ड फ्रॉम द लोअर स्पीसीज ओवर मैनी मिलेनिया। द मेन असेट दैट मेड ह्यूमन सुपीरियर टू अदर स्पीसीज वॉज द एबिलिटी टू रीजन, द एबिलिटी टू थिंक। How well this ability can be used depends on each person's power of reasoning. How to develop this power? Here we shall discuss the process of reasoning, especially in the context of mathematics. In mathematical language, there are two kinds of reasoning. One is inductive and the other is deductive. We have already discussed the inductive reasoning in the context of mathematical induction. In this chapter, we shall discuss some fundamentals of deductive reasoning. First, we shall define statement in mathematics. A sentence is called mathematically acceptable statement if it is either true or false, but not both. So, looking at the sentence, if you can say whether it is either true or false, okay, clearly, then you can say that is a statement. But if that given sentence, sometimes it can be true, sometimes it can be false, so there is a dilemma, okay? So that kind of sentence you cannot say as a statement in mathematics. So in mathematically, statement means the given sentence should be either true or false, okay? It should not be both. For example, 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. You know that this is true always, so it is a statement. All prime numbers are odd numbers. Now it is a false. Why? Because 2 is prime, but it is not odd. It is even. Therefore, this is a statement. Some sentences are vague or ambiguous. Now some statements are not clear. Okay. For example, x plus y greater than 0. Here as x and y are unknown, therefore we cannot say whether it is true or false. Okay. We cannot say whether it is true or false. Therefore, this one is also not a statement. False if x equal to minus 8 and y is equal to 1. So if you take minus 8 plus 1, answer is minus 7, which is less than 0. So this sentence will become false. True if x is equal to 8 and y is equal to minus 2, as 8 minus 2 is equal to 6 greater than 0. So it becomes true. But it depends on the value of x and y. So it is not clear. Okay, it is vague or ambiguous. Therefore, this given sentence also is not a statement. Sentences that exclamation, order, question are not statements. So even if you have got a sentence and which have got exclamation inside it, order or question, then those sentences are also not statement in mathematics. For example, how beautiful, this is exclamation, so not a statement. Open the door, this is an order, so not statement. Where are you going, this is a question, so not a statement. Variable places such as here, there, etc. So places, if particular place is given, yes, you can call that maybe statement. But if you are using variable places, for example, like here, there, okay, then you cannot say that this will be statement. It can be only sentence. Now with this, we can start exercise 14.1. Question number one, which of the following sentences are statements? Give reason for your answer. Roman number 1, there are 35 days in a month. Statement. Why? Because you can clearly say that this sentence is false, right? You don't have dilemma of whether it will be true or false. We know clearly that no month will have 35 days, right? So this is a false sentence. We can say clearly that it is false. Therefore, it is a statement, right? So I have written, no month has 35 days. This sentence is always false. Therefore, it is mathematical statement. Roman number 2, mathematics is difficult. Now, this depends on each person. For some people, it may be easy. For some people, it may be difficult, right? So, it has got no fixed answer, whether true or false. It has got both the answers, depending on a person. So, this is not a statement in mathematics. This sentence is subjective in the sense that for those who understand, it may be easy. and others may be difficult. Okay, so therefore this is not a statement, right? For by the definition of the statement, either it should be true or false, it should not be both. And in this question, I mean this sentence can be true for some people and false for some people, right? So it has got both the answers, right? It should not be both, but it has both the answer, therefore it is not a statement in mathematics. Roman number 3, the sum of 5 and 7 is greater than 10. This is a statement. Okay, why? Because 5 plus 7 is already greater than 10. We know that, and this is always true, therefore it is a statement. Number 4, the square of a number is even number. This is also not statement. Why? Because the correctness of the sentence depends upon the number that is squared. So it depends on the number which you are squaring it. Okay, for example, 2 square is equal to 4, which is even. Then this statement is true. But 3 square is equal to 9, which is odd, this sentence becomes false. That means for this number it is true, for this number it is false. That means it has got both the answers. Therefore, this is not a statement. Number 5, the size of quadrilateral have equal length. Not statement. Since sentence is not always true, is not a statement. Okay, this sentence is not always true. For example, square and rhombus has equal size. So if you take a square, you know all the four sides are equal. If you take rhombus, all the four sides are equal in the length, right? But if you take a trapezium and rectangle, then the four sides are not equal, right? So for some it is true, some it is false. Therefore this given sentence is not a statement. Number 6, answer this question. Not a statement. Why? Because this is an order. The sentence is an order, therefore it is not a statement. Okay, already I said that if it is order, it is not a statement in mathematics. Number 7, the product of minus 1 and 8 is 8. Now this is not true, correct? Minus 1 and 8 should be minus 8, the product of minus 1 and 8. So you know this is always false. Therefore, it is a statement, okay, because there is no doubt whether it will be true or false. It will be always false, so you can say it is a statement in mathematics. It is always false, therefore it is statement. Number 8, the sum of all interior angles of a triangle is 180. You know this is always true, right? Therefore, it is a statement. This sentence is always true, it's a statement. Number 9, today is a windy day. Now, today is referred to which day is not clear, okay? It can be any day, therefore it is not a statement. It is not clear from the context which day is referred, therefore it is not a statement. Okay, today can be any day. Okay, therefore it is not a statement. Number 10, all real numbers are complex numbers. This is a statement. This sentence is always true because all real numbers can be written as a plus I into 0. Therefore, it is a statement. Okay, so this is a true statement. Therefore, we can say that it is a statement. This sentence is true, so it is a statement. And you know that complex numbers are written as a plus ib. Okay, we have not taken this chapter, but we know that a plus ib is a form of writing the complex number. So this given sentence is a statement. Question number 2, give 3 examples of sentences which are not statements. Give reasons for the answer. Now I'm giving 3 examples. You can give many examples according to the definition of a statement. Okay, you have to give an example which have got both the answers. Sometimes it can be true also, sometimes it can be false also. Then that sentence you call it as not a statement. Okay, so if it should have either particular answer, if it is true then always true, if it is false then always false, then that will be statement. But we have to give the example which are not statement. Not statement means you know that it can be sometimes true, sometimes false, both the answers possible, then you can say that that is not a statement. Okay, and I have given you some first I have given you this, that if your sentence have got exclamation, order or question, then you know that they are not statement. Okay, then if they are variable places, then also they are not a statement. Okay, so these things you can keep in mind and write according to you can write many sentences which are not a statement. Okay, I have written 3 because they have asked us to write 3. First example I have taken, who are you? Okay, this is a question, right? So this is a question, therefore it is not a statement. The sentence is an interrogative, therefore hence it's not a statement. Number 2, Gujarat is far from here. Now it is here, okay, the variable place, therefore this is also not a statement. The sentence contains here, which is variable place, therefore it is not a statement. Third example, she is medical student. Now here, this is not a statement. Why? Because here, she is who? Not a particular person, right? She can be anyone. So because of this coming she, we can say that this is not a statement. Okay, it is just a sentence. So it is not a statement in mathematics. We'll keep this much for today, and with this we also end the exercise 14.1. Thank you very much.